Hey guys, I am Aditya again to help you out with your physics, and today's topic is equipotential surfaces characteristics. In our previous video I have told you that what are equipotential surfaces, but in this video we will go on with the characteristics of equipotential surface. So our first characteristic is the work done in moving a charge in an or along the equipotential surface is always equal to zero. For example, let me take an equipotential surface like this. So a circle, as I have already told you, is an equipotential surface, and this is the center of the circle, and here goes the radius. And radius is same at all directions, so it's A and it is B. And a charge, point charge Q is placed here. Now we will find out the potential at A position, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q is the charge, by R is the distance between the charge and the point. So Q by R, VB will be similarly 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q is the charge, by the distance between the charge and the position, so Q by R once again. Therefore VA is equal to VB in an equipotential surface. Therefore del V, that is VA minus VB, is equal to zero. Now we have a formula, work done W is equal to Q into del V. So if Q is there and del V is zero, therefore work done is zero. So we can move a charge from A position to B position or from any position to any position on an equipotential surface easily without any work done, without any force applied, without any work done. Now this is our first characteristic. Now we'll go on to our second characteristic, that is two equipotential surfaces never intersect. Why they do not intersect? Two equipotential surfaces never intersect. Now, if I consider this as two equipotential surfaces, then if they intersect at this particular position, there will be two directions. And in reality, there cannot be two directions at a particular single position. So, two equipotential surfaces can never intersect. So, this was our second most important characteristics. Now, third important characteristics is, I'm just rubbing out number one. So, let's write number three. So, third characteristics. See, if this is the position of electric field intensity, now we are moving the charge on an equipotential surface. So dr will of course be in this direction. Electric field intensity is always perpendicular to the direction of dr in equipotential surfaces. So electric field is always, and dr shows or dr implies the direction of equipotential surface. What can a direction of an equipotential surface be? An equipotential surface is a circle, so in this case a tangent shows the direction of a circle at a particular position. So this is the tangent here, dr. Therefore, dr also signifies the equipotential surface direction. So electric field is always perpendicular to the equipotential surface direction. Now we will also prove this just like the number one. Now we know a formula, dv is equal to minus of edr. Now if we denote this as vector equation, then it becomes e dot dr. Okay, dv is equal to minus of e dot dr. This is electric field potential, is the electric field is the negative potential gradient, which I have also shown in another video. And so from here we'll take out the following characteristic. Now dv is actually what? Dv is actually dv. Yes. So let me first denote it scalar one. So minus of edr, since it's the dot product, cos theta. If theta is the angle, if I consider this angle as theta, then it is cos theta. Now dv is del v, and for an equipotential surface, del v is always equal to 0, because va is equal to vb. Therefore va minus vb is equal to 0, I have shown already. So 0 is equal to minus edr cos theta. Since edr cannot be equal to 0, it's a product, so it cannot be equal to 0. Therefore cos theta has to be equal to 0. Therefore cos theta is equal to, for 0 we'll write cos 90, because cos 90 is equal to 0 and theta becomes 90 degree. So we have proved it, that this theta, the angle between equipotential surface and the electric field, theta is always equal to 90 degree. So electric field is always perpendicular to the equipotential surface direction. Hope this video will help you, and if it helps you, please click the button below, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.